Hello everyone, today I am going to explain about the alternative forms of pull-ups. Okay, alternative forms of pull-up. Okay, so here if you consider an inverter, so previously we discussed about the NMOS inverter. In that one, the upper transistor is called as pull-up transistor and lower transistor is called as pull-down transistor. Okay, so similarly, so that pull-up transistor or pull-up device, we have four types of pull-ups. Okay, so that is, first one is, here we have alternative forms of pull-ups, means here we have four alternative forms. Okay, so the first one is what? Resistive pull-up. Resistive pull-up. And second one is depletion MOSFET as pull-up transistor. Second one is depletion MOSFET. And the third one is enhancement MOSFET as pull-up. Enhancement MOSFET as pull-up. Okay, MOSFET as pull-up transistor. And the final one is the very important one, that is CMOS, that is complementary metal oxide semiconductor, okay, technology. That is, in this one, PMOS can be used as, PMOS is pull-up. Okay, so if you observe this one, what are the alternative forms of pull-up means? Here, the if you consider the inverter circuit, suppose here, this one is like this. So here we have VSS or ground, and this one is VDD, and here we are going to take the output, right? Okay, here we are going to take the output. So this one is called as what? Pull-up. Pull-up. If you take any inverter, it is out in the form. This one is pull-down. Here we always take this one is NMOS transistor, in the NMOS transistor. Right? So here NMOS enhancement transistor we will take. But the pull-up will varies. That pull-up transistor will varies. And here we have these types of pull-ups. Okay? So this pull-up transistors will be of these four. Okay, so we can use any of these four, that is pull-up, in place of pull-up we can use a resistive load. Okay, and another one is we can use pull-up transistor as depletion MOSFET as a pull-up, and we can also use enhancement MOSFET as a pull-up, and we can use PMOS transistor as pull-up. Okay, so like that, if you observe this one, inverter circuit is of the form, or any digital one here, if you consider, okay, so it consists of pull down network and pull up network. But if you consider a particularly that inverter circuit, okay, in this, the pull up will be, the pull down will be same transistor we are going to use, that is NMOS transistor. That pull up will be varies, and pull up we have these alternative forms. Okay, so this is about how we can call this one as alternative forms of pull-up. Okay, so here the NMOS pull-down is always same, but the pull-up transistor will be various, pull-up circuit will be various. This is of four types. Okay, so this is about the alternative forms, how many types we have. Okay, so now here if I go with one by one, that is resistive load, and this one, if I go with the resistive load, so this one is already we discussed, okay, and here already we discussed at the time of NMOS inverter with depletion load, okay, or depletion MOSFET as a pull-up. Okay, so these two are we have discussed already, but I will explain briefly here. Okay, so here if you consider, this is the RL, and this one is what? NMOS transistor here we have. Okay, so here we have NMOS transistor. Okay, so that is our full down, right? NMOS transistor. So we know that if Vin is equal to 0, Vin is equal to 0, if I consider this one as T1, so T1 will be off, and there is no current will flow, so there is no connection with this V out, and the VDD will obtained as the V out. So V out is equal to approximately VDD. If I remove, or if I cannot consider the drop across this RL, so V out will be VDD. So next, if I consider V in is equal to 1, so T1 will be on. Here 0 and 1 means logic 0 and logic 1. Okay, logic 0 means 0 volts and logic 1 means 5 volts. So if I give 5 volts, T1 will be on and V out is equal to 0. V out equal to 0 because the current will flows from VDD to VSS. Okay, more amount of current will flows and V out is approximately equal to 0. So this is the basic operation of inverter with pull up as resistive load as pull up. Okay, so and what are the limitations of this one? So first one is it occupies more space on the silicon wafer. Okay, so it occupies more space, that is the main disadvantage. And the second one is, okay, the power dissipation is also more. Okay, so to avoid this one, disadvantage or limitation, so we'll go for what? The transistor, the pull up as a transistor. Okay, that is pull up at the place of pull up. Okay, in the place of pull up, we will consider the NMOS, or we can also consider the PMOS, or we can also consider the NMOS depletion MOSFET. Okay, so the remaining three, what we have here is nothing but the same thing. That is, this resistive load will be replaced, or the pull up will be replaced with the depletion MOSFET, enhancement MOSFET, NMOS enhancement MOSFET, and at the same time PMOS or PMOS enhancement transistor we will use. Okay, so these are the three types we are going to use here. Out of that, the first one is load resistance as a pull up, and it has these limitations. Okay, so next, what we have here is the second one. Here we have is NMOS depletion transistor as pull up. Okay, so if you consider this one here, this gate is gate and drain, and this one is the source. Okay, so this is the source here, and this one is the drain, and here it is source, and this one is the gate. Okay, so here if you consider, this one is the NMOS transistor, and this one is the depletion MOSFET. Okay, depletion MOSFET of N type. Okay, so this one is the depletion MOSFET. So similarly here, depletion MOSFET, here the gate is all connected to the source. Okay, so and VGS is equal to 0 here. Here what happened? VGS is equal to 0. Okay, and but if you consider the depletion MOSFET, its threshold voltage is negative, so this transistor is always in the on condition, and depending on the Vin values what we are giving, okay, so the output will be depends. Okay, so therefore similarly what we consider, Vin is equal to 0, so this will be in off condition if I consider this one as T1 and this one as T2. Okay, already we have discussed the detailed characteristics, voltage transfer characteristics, that is the graph drawn between output and input. Okay, so that is here we have. Okay, so up to threshold voltage, if I give, that is Vin equal to 0, V out is equal to VDD, because this transistor will be off and there is no connection with the output through this to this T2, so the VDD will comes out of here V out. Okay, so next one is, if Vin is greater than 0, Vin is greater value or positive value, Vin is nothing but the VGS, okay, gate and source voltage, if I increases that positive. So after crossing this threshold voltage, okay, so after crossing the threshold voltage of this NMOS transistor, what happened here? The transistor T2 will be on. Okay, T2 will be on. And if you observe this one at 0 voltage, Vin is equal to 0. So here we have output is VDD. Okay, as I increases the Vin value, so gradually after reaching this threshold voltage, this transistor will be on and the voltage, the output voltage will be drops. Okay, because this transistor, if I increases further and further, so there will be a direct current will flows from VDD to the VSS. Okay, so there is more amount of current will flows between the two rails, that is VDD rail and at the same time ground or VSS. Okay, so the power dissipation will be more. That is the disadvantage of depletion MOSFET. Okay, so here after crossing the threshold voltage, the transistor T2 will be on and there will be a dropping of this output voltage from VDD to the non-zero value. Okay, because both the transistor will goes into the on condition, so that there will be a current will flows from VDD to ESS. Okay, so that is the limitation. Here we have more amount of current will flows. Okay, so here what are the limitations? This one is transfer characteristics, already we have seen this. So now dissipation is high since the rail to rail current is flows when Vin is equal to logic 1 or VDD. Okay, so this is the main disadvantage or limitation here. Here we have, this can be avoided by using a CMOS inverter. So here the dissipation is high since rail to rail current. I already told that after crossing this threshold voltage VT, okay, input crosses the threshold voltage. So what happened here, this transistor goes into the saturation and at the same time more amount of current will flows because this one is on and this one is on. So there will be a high amount of flow, current will flows between VDD and ground, and there is a less output will be obtained at the output side. So that's why gradually the output will be decreases and it reaches to a non-zero amount. Okay, so this is about the characteristics. So but here dissipation is high since the rail to rail current is flows when Vin is equal to logic 1 or VDD. Okay, now what is another limitation here? Switching off output from 1 to 0 begins when Vin exceeds the threshold voltage of a pull down device. Okay, until that until reaching of the threshold voltage, there is no movement. That means there is no conversion of logic 1 to logic 0. Okay, will take place. Okay, that is another one. And next, when switching the output from 1 to 0, okay, the pull up device is non saturation initially, and this presents the lower resistance through which the charge the capacitive load. Okay, so here what happened here? So until it is reaches, after reaching the threshold voltage, okay, so at a particular time, so the transistor will be in non-saturation. After that, if we increase more and more Vin value beyond this threshold voltage, what happened here? So the transistor goes into the saturation and it offers very less resistance. Due to that, the capacitive loads, whatever we have connected, they can be easily charged. Okay, so this is about the NMOS depletion transistor as pull up. Okay, now next one is here, NMOS enhancement mode as pull up. Okay, here we have considered NMOS depletion mode as pull up. Now here we have NMOS enhancement mode, and there is a one connection difference here. The channel is already present, you all know that depletion MOSFET. And here if you observe this one, the depletion MOSFET gate is connected to the source. Okay, here the depletion MOSFET gate is connected to the source. Okay, but here if you observe this one, this is the gate and this one is the drain, right? Okay, so instead of connecting this gate to the source, shorted with the gate to the source, here we are shorting the gate of the enhancement transistor to the VDD. Okay, gate of the enhancement transistor, that is T1, to the VDD here. That means what here? So the T1, that is the enhancement pull-up, is always in the on condition, because if this gate is sorted with the VDD. Okay, the gate is sorted with the VDD. That means VGG is equal to gate voltage is equal to drain voltage, that is VDD. Okay, so VDD is nothing but it is 5 volts. Okay, so if it is 5 volts means it will, the transistor will goes into the saturation region. Actually, for enhancement mode transistor, the typical value of threshold voltage is 0.2 VDD. Okay, but here we are applying VDD. Okay, at the gate we are applying VDD because this is shorted here. Okay, so that is the main difference between this NMOS enhancement transistor and this NMOS depletion transistor as the pull-up load. Okay, so if I give this gate is connected with the drain or shorted with the drain, so what happened here, VGG is equal to VDD. This transistor will be always on. Okay, and here if you observe this one, this transistor is as it is, this one is the NMOS enhancement transistor, and whatever the input we are applying, that is VN equal to 0, so what happened, and VN is equal to some value that is greater than the threshold voltage, what happened, we will see here. Okay, so here I am taking that this is the transistor 2, enhancement transistor 1 and enhancement transistor 2. Okay, so initially this one is connected with the VDD. Okay, so this is shorted and this will be on condition, and VN is equal to 0 means that means below this threshold voltage. Okay, below this threshold voltage of input, if VN is less than VT2. VN is less than VD2. Here we are not applying any input voltage. Only here we are applying, that is input voltage. So that VN is less than VT2. So T2 will be in off condition. Okay. So T2 is off. So T2 is off. And at the same time here, what is the voltage we will get? Okay. So I will write here. If VN is less than VT2, that means what? VN is less than VT2 means the threshold voltage of the transistor 2. VT2 is nothing but threshold voltage of T2, that is transistor 2. If it is less than VT2 and at the same time VGG is equal to VDD of T1, okay, then T1 is on and T2 is off, then what is the Vout? Vout is what? Okay, so Vout is what here? Here there is no problem, whenever it is off condition directly this VDD will be obtained at the output side. But here it is not the case. Vout is what? Okay. So Vout is nothing but here Vout is equal to, we cannot get exact value of VDD. Okay. We don't get exact value of VDD as the output. Instead of that we will get VDD minus VT1. Okay. So here Vout is equal to degraded value or decreased value of VDD we will get. We cannot get exact value or logic 1. Okay. Exact logic 1 we'll get. Now we cannot get when VGG is equal to VDD. So the transistor T1 will be on and T2 will be off. That is VN is less than VD2. So therefore Vout is equal to VDD minus VT1. We cannot get exact value of logic 1. Okay. This is the one of the limitation of this inverter, that is enhancement transistor used as a pull-up. Okay, this is the main limitation of this structure. Okay, so this is the limitation. Okay, if you observe here, we'll get directly VDD as the output. Okay, but here we don't get the VDD. Because why we are getting here? So we will get VGS or the threshold voltage of depletion MOSFET is negative value. Okay, so here we will get VDD directly, right? Or
here VGS is nothing but it is sorted. There it is sorted with the source. So VGS is approximately 0. Okay. So therefore VDD minus 0 is V out. Okay. So we'll get V out is equal to VDD exact value. But here we don't get the exact value. That is the main difference between the this depletion load and at the same time enhancement transistor as a load. Okay. So this is one what we can here clearly it is observed that it is the output. It is we got is VDD minus VT1 is the output. You can observe. So this one is actually VDD, but the output curve is this one. Okay, the output curve is this one. Okay, so before VT2, that is threshold voltage, that is applied voltage is less than the threshold voltage. So here we are getting up to this point VDD minus VT1. So here we cannot get the exact value of logic 1. So after that what happened? If Vin is greater than VT2, so T2 will be goes into the on condition. So again the output voltage will drops to the non-zero value because both the transistors will be in on condition. So this transistor will be on and this transistor will be on. So the current will flows directly between VDD and VSS. So because of that the output will be very less, and but it is not zero. Okay, it is a non-zero output we'll get. Non-zero output. So this is the transfer characteristics of voltage transfer characteristics of NMOS enhancement transistor. So here the dissipation is high since the current flows when Vin is equal to logic 1. When Vin is equal to logic 1, both the transistors T1 and T2 will be on. T1 and T2 is on. Current flow between VDD and VSS, that is between two rails, the current will flows. Because of that, the power dissipation is high. It's like this one. Okay. So after that, when V out can never reach VDD, what is the reason? When VGG is equal to VDD, okay, when VGG is equal to VDD, so this transistor will be on and this transistor will be in off condition, okay, if Vin is equal to 0. So what happened now? VDD minus VTP, VT1 will get as the output, so it is less than the VDD, so never get the logic 1, okay. So this is about the NMOS enhancement mode pull-up. If you use the NMOS enhancement mode pull-up, so these are the limitations what we have here. And another two limitations here we have is VGG may be derived from a switching source. Okay, so VGG directly if you connect this one, okay, there is no problem. Or otherwise we have to get from another source, that is VGG. Okay, if VGG is higher than VDD, then extra supply. Actually here there is no problem if VGG is connected with the VDD. But if you want to apply VGG that is greater than VDD, okay. So here if you short this one here, okay, if you short that one here, VGG is equal to VDD only, okay. But I want more amount of VGG. At that point I have to supply. I have to supply from another source, okay. I have to supply from another voltage source. That is what the disadvantage, another disadvantage. So VGG may be derived from a switching source. And next one is if VGG is higher than VDD, then an extra supply rail is required. That is very important point here. But here generally we will short these two. Okay. So this VGG is shorted with the drain, that is VDD. And at the same time, if you want to operate the inverter, that is at VGG greater than VDD, then you require another source. That is also a limitation of this NMOS enhancement transistor. Okay. NMOS enhancement transistor if you use the pull-up for the inverter. Okay. So the main disadvantages are two. One is what? We can never get the logic 1, exact logic 1 value, that is VDD. Instead of that, we'll get VDD minus VT1. Right. And another thing is
there is a requirement of extra source supply if you consider VGG is greater than VDD. If you want to operate VGG is greater than VDD, that means you require another source. So these are the limitations of this NMOS enhancement mode pull-up. Okay, so to avoid these limitations, so we'll go for the next one is PMOS transistor as pull-up. PMOS as pull-up. Okay, PMOS as pull-up. Right, the NMOS will be present as it is, and we will replace this enhancement transistor, or we will replace this depletion MOSFET, or we can replace this load, resistive load, with what? The PMOS transistor. Okay, so here if you observe that one, how the diagram will be. Okay, so here I am representing the PMOS as like this, right? So what is the difference between PMOS and NMOS means, if I use the bubble here, so that becomes PMOS, and NMOS will be as it is, that is, it is VSS, or we can say that it is a ground. Okay, so what I have done, here, it is the output, V out. Right, so here, this one is the PMOS transistor, that is, acts as a pull-up. In this technology is called as what? CMOS technology. So CMOS technology. Technology we call our CMOS inverter. This one is CMOS inverter. Right? So here we will short the gates of both PMOS and NMOS and we'll give here the input. Okay. So this one is the PMOS and this one is the NMOS. Right, so to avoid all the limitations here, so I am replacing the pull-up of depletion or resistive load or enhancement transistor with the PMOS transistor. Okay, so here this is the difference between the symbols that we represent, NMOS transistor, and if you use the bubble here, it will becomes the PMOS transistor. Between this PMOS and NMOS, we are going to take the output. This one is VDD and VSS are ground. So this is the circuit that is the replacement for all these limitations, and this is the circuit that is called as CMOS inverter. Okay, so in this CMOS inverter, the PMOS and NMOS both are complementary pairs. Okay, so PMOS comma NMOS are complementary pair. Complementary pair, so it is called as CMOS inverter, that is complementary metal oxide semiconductor inverter. Okay, so this is the another what we call alternative form of pull-up. Okay, so we'll discuss thoroughly about this CMOS inverter in the next discussion. Okay, so just I have introduced, okay, here the alternative forms of CMOS pull-up. Here, there is nothing but pull-up is what? PMOS used as a pull-up instead of depletion MOSFET or instead of enhancement MOSFET or instead of resistive load to avoid all the limitations. Okay, so this is about our alternative forms of pull-up for us. Okay, thank you.